Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari, and I should have my head handed to me. This is a demo of a scary game. For best picture quality, please adjust the tracking controller on your VCR. No voices have been recorded for the following demo, final game, feature, cutscenes. Memories and possibilities are ever more hideous than realities. Herbert West, 1922, of course, from H.P. Lovecraft. I hope you can hear me over this. I've just adjusted the volume for the music, but it doesn't change this opening scene. So this is a demo of an upcoming game by, if I'm saying this wrong, Austin Cordes and Senscape Productions. Josh Mandel is the voice of King Graham in a few games, producers on some of the earlier King's Quest games. King's Quest games. And he was the voice of the protagonist in Serena, which was a sort of community project involving Austin, which is written Augustine, but he says it Austin. Yeah, and some other people in the adventure game industry. Yikes! She had a mustache, too. I kickstarted this game in 2013. Believe it or not. So this game has been in development for over 7 years, because it was in the beginning of 2013. Oh, must be a relation. Relation to Austin. So now we're driving on the grass. Looks like a kind of path there, maybe, or just a clearing, but we're driving on the grass. I don't do good with horror games. I don't like jump scares. And I don't like being chased. Especially, I can't even watch people sometimes get chased. Or the anticipation of the scene. So hopefully this is very light. This is more adventure than horror. But they finally came out with a full demo, about 2 hours long, so it's probably going to take me 3 hours to play it. And since I backed the game way back when, I felt like I going to have to play it. There I was, after all those years, at the threshold of a nightmarish place. I'd never thought I'd have the courage to return. Now this, as it says, is not voice, so you're going to have to put up with my voice reading all the things, and I do read all the things. Hanwell Mental Institute, yeah. So you can get this for free up to June 26 at some point, 2020, on GOG and Steam. So I like the way this looks like an actual, you know, really old, like, patient record ledger kind of thing. Now the settings, I'm guessing visual acuity here is the graphics. I put the very high, and then light sensitivity, I'm guessing this is the gamma settings. This we can't change. Speed of reflexes, so it's crossed out, the things we can't change. But you would have, you know, again, this is a demo, it's not representative, you know, not exactly the finished product will be much better. Visual snow syndrome. See, they need to explain what these things will actually do in game terms. I mean, you're checking this stuff. I'm guessing visual snow syndrome. I'm not really sure what setting that would be. I mean, these are graphic settings. Maybe one of them is blur, motion blur. And the other one is your anti-aliasing or something. This is, I think, mouse. Changing the mouse, you know. And then, of course, here we actually see music, sound, speech. So I turn these down. Unfortunately, subtitles are not available, and that's basically it for this. Now, I don't think there's, like, actual walking, at least in this part. You can look around and click on things. Why was I doing this? I need to know what had happened to me. I'd rather face the direful truth than live in blissful oblivion. Wait. Okay. Alright, so this is neat. As I grabbed the notepad, I was struck by a sense of confidence I hadn't expected. I felt ready to tackle the mysteries of that looming structure. Now, the notepad is like your quest log. I wonder if I can... okay. Yeah, no. Okay. Now, you can interact with a few things. No signal. Shame. I could use some company. That's basically it. I try to look at myself. So I've played a very small amount of this. Just talking to someone in here, and that's it. I felt like I was prepared to unearth whatever secrets were concealed inside that monolithic bedlam. So you right-click to open journal. Okay, there's the journal. Enter the Institute. Hopefully I would find the answers I needed inside the Hanwell Mental Institute. This was... wait. All I needed to do was open the front door and face my past. So you can speed it up? No, it's just... never mind. You could speed up in dialogue. Oh, I hit escape to make the notepad go away and I went to that. Okay, so... It's 8:00 p.m. Welcome to the Hanwell Mental Institute. What can I do for you? Well, this is strange. I thought the building was abandoned. As you can see, that's no longer the case. My name is Julia, and I'm the receptionist for the Institute. Why are you here? That's a very good question. This is an uncomfortable situation. I was hoping to explore the building. Oh. But you thought it was abandoned. Indeed. That's why I suppose nobody would mind. We certainly do mind. The Institute was never abandoned, just closed to the public until recently. And still, abandoned or not, it's not like just anyone can walk inside. You do realize that. This caught me completely by surprise. I'm not sure what to say. Try explaining yourself. Why did you want to see the building? So now we've got topics and people. Julia. If I hit this again, though, I simply wanted to visit the place. We share some history. I can't let you do that. You'd need an appointment, and we aren't even scheduling them yet. Perhaps if I explain my situation, you might consider making an exception? I sincerely doubt it, but you can try. I was really hoping to visit the building. Again, I can't possibly let you in without a good reason, and I don't even know who you are. I understand. Let's try discussing another topic, then. That might be a good idea. Let's start with why you're here. Now, we can't keep choosing this. So would you please let me in? I'm sorry. Like I told you, that wouldn't be responsible. I can't let any stranger in. What if I were visiting someone? Are you? Well, no. There you go. There aren't many patients to visit yet anyway. Look, it's important that I take a look around. I won't tear the place down. I'm genuinely sorry. You seem decent enough to me, but I can't allow you to enter without a good reason. Fine. Then I'll try to explain myself. Yes, you mentioned that you wanted to discuss another topic. I'm wondering how many times you can pull the string here and get new responses. You really won't let me in? No, at least not until you give me a good reason. Okay. Yeah, if you click again, it just stops the scrolling of the words. Julia. So you are the receptionist here? Yes, this is my first night. I do a bit of everything. Right now, the Institute is operating with minimal staff until renovations are complete. The subject is giving me a headache. Really? Okay, we're on to topics then. Now, this game took so long to develop because, from what I understand, they started using a completely new engine halfway through it, and had to do everything over again. So, the plus side is going to be even better quality and such. The downside as well, it probably would have been out by now. Building not abandoned? The last thing I expected was to find people here tonight. I assume the Institute had shut down indefinitely. Not indefinitely. It's true that it ceased to operate for a few years, but we're in the process of reopening. The structure is still usable, and the overcrowding of hospitals in the region has compelled authorities to reconsider this place. Process of reopening. So, let me get this straight. The entire Institute is being reopened? Yes. Patients from smaller hospitals in the region are being relocated here, and heavier renovations will start tomorrow. It's rather empty, though. Tonight it's just me, security, Dr. Miller, and a few patients in the building. Still, it's good to see it breathing new life. Patients being relocated. You mentioned patients are being relocated? Correct. There are hardly any people here tonight. However, I have a fleet of workers arriving first thing tomorrow morning. I understand the plan is to have the Institute operating at full capacity in 10 days. That's ambitious, given the state of the building. It looks worse than it really is, you know. Does it now? Dr. Miller. Well, let me exhaust these topics. My condition. The situation is hard for me to explain. This isn't my first time here. Oh, I'm new myself. This is my first night here. So you used to work for the Institute? No, not really. I was a patient. Well, I'm not sure what I can help you with then. Why are you here? It's a good question. Why I'm here. You're not inspiring much confidence. Should I call security? Please, no. That won't be necessary. I promise. I'll explain myself. Just give me a moment. Sorry for being touchy, but I have doubts about a complete stranger visiting a mental hospital at night. It wouldn't be responsible to let you in. Complete stranger. There's a reason why I'm acquainted with this place, you know. Oh? I've been curious since you showed up in the first place. All right, here goes. I was once admitted as a patient of this hospital. Oh. Don't worry. It was nothing serious. Just a short stay. I'm not crazy. Well, you don't sound like a lunatic to me. I'll give you that. I still don't see why you want to visit the building. Well, why would she even use topics like that? She's a receptionist and a... That's not professional. Is there anything troubling you? Oh, this is crossed out. All right, before I... I'm going to exhaust these topics a little bit more, see what else she might have to say. So there are more people here? Patients too? Yes. Although we're operating with a greatly reduced staff, the building is far from ready, as you can see, so mostly low-risk patients have been admitted. In this state? I don't understand. It could use some cleaning, I won't deny that, and I'm freezing to death without those radiators working, but you can rest assured it can hold a few patients. I was under the impression nobody cared about this place anymore, which is why I thought it wouldn't hurt to have a quick look around. You could have gotten hurt, though. It's not particularly safe. For instance, right now no one is allowed on the third floor, which is crumbling to splinters. This is all so strange. I'm still not sure what to believe. You need to believe the truth. The Institute is reopening and back to work. All right, so that's exhausted. My condition... I'll get back to explaining what I must do here. I just need to find the right words. That's fine by me. We have all night. I don't have all night. You're a problem, not mine. Still trying to figure out how to explain my situation. Take your time. I guess I didn't think this through. All I felt today was I need to get to Hanwell. I can't help you there. You sound like you need to figure something out. Okay. But where are all the workers? I don't see any ongoing construction or renovations. It's nighttime. People usually don't work at night, except staff in charge of critical tasks. Such as you. Absolutely. The Institute couldn't possibly work without me, giving warm welcomes to strangers in the night. Something tells me I'm annoying you. Not really. It's nice to have some company right now. Okay. Don't you find it strange that they're reopening the Institute after all this time? There's nothing odd about this. Authorities deemed the building usable. Other places didn't fare as well and have been demolished. What other places? Okay, that's done. Okay. Reasons for commitment. So this isn't a subject I like to talk about. It was a traumatic period in my life, and it hurts to even think about it. I had a, they called it acute stress reaction, which led to a more problematic episode. I committed myself voluntarily. I'm sorry to hear that. It's understandable you don't want to think about it, though. But isn't this counterproductive, then, being here again? On the contrary, you could say I need to make amends, face my past. Alright, so now we can talk about Dr. Miller. Who's Dr. Miller? He's the current director of the Institute, and he's overseeing the entire reopening process. I thought Hanwell was the director. That was a long time ago. Where can I find Dr. Miller? I'm sorry. I can't tell you. Huh. I don't want to talk about this anymore. Really? Alright. Don't you sometimes feel as if you're not in control of your own actions? Honestly, no. Nobody understands me. Remembering my past. Is there anything new to say here, though? Forgive me for insisting, but I must go in. Forgive me for saying no again. What if I just walked in? What if I just called security? Good answer. Alright. Remembering my past. The truth is, I'm having these peculiar nightmares. I believe something happened to me here that won't let me be at peace. Something? I feel you've been intentionally vague since you entered that door. Honestly, I remember little from that time in my life, but I was fine for a long time, many years even, until suddenly my dreams pull me back. I have been thinking about this Institute for the past several weeks, and today I realized I needed to come here one more time. It's a compelling story. I'm intrigued, though I'm still not sure what you're trying to accomplish here. How would this help your situation? It's been bothering me for weeks, this feeling that I need to do or understand something, almost as if I forgot to do something here. We all feel a bit like that sometimes. Did you try going to therapy? No, it's not like that. I simply know that I have to be here, just not why. I have nothing else to say about this. Alright, we need to get in. Is it okay if I go in now? I don't know. I'm sorry. I really can't. You still won't trust me? You look alright to me, but I still don't understand why you want to see the Institute. Really, all I need to do is walk around, get a feel of this place. Are you a reporter? Or maybe you're writing a book. That's it. No, that's not it either. It is called security. Okay, anything new here? New people. Topics. About my past. Yes, I still don't understand what you expect to do here. If I could just get a feel of this place again, I'm sure I could leave my past behind, Recognize it will help me understand what happened to me. And then hopefully your nightmares will go away? That's the plan, at least. Okay. I trust you. Just like that. So you trust me now? Yes, your story is strange, but I'm intrigued. I feel for your situation, although I'm a bit concerned that you're an ex-patient. Please don't get me wrong. No offense taken. That's true. Guess I should have claimed that I was a doctor. I give you points for being honest, though. You seem nice. I didn't scare you with the story about my nightmares, right? No, you didn't. The Institute gives me the creeps, too, especially now that it's starting to get dark. I'm just trying to decide the best way to explain myself. Don't stress yourself out. I promise this will eventually make sense. You've got my full attention. Okay. So apparently we can just go in now? Can I just... How do I... Alright, so you know everything. Will you let me in? Well, it's a highly unusual situation, but I care about your story. It's not like you can cause much trouble, and if you do, Bruno will have a not-so-friendly talk with you. Bruno, are you positive this won't be counterproductive to your health? Yes, I feel better than ever. I just need to take a look around and try to remember what it was like to be a patient at the Institute. And you will take full responsibility for your safety? I assume all the risks. I suppose I don't have to sign anything. Let's talk rules, then. You must leave before dawn. Workers arriving early, and they will turn the place inside out. This is upside down. And steer clear of the upper floors. The doors are locked anyway. Do we have an agreement? Yes, we do. Thank you so much, Julia. You have no idea what this means to me. Very well. Go ahead. Feel free to take a walk inside. I hope you find what you're looking for. Me too. Something tells me this is my last chance before the Institute I knew ceases to be. It will be a different place in the morning, that's for sure. Right-click to end the conversation. Let me just see if there's any more topics we can unearth. I don't want to talk about this. What about Bruno? Bruno is here. You mentioned someone... Bruno? Yes, he's our security guy. Grouchy and fairly unpleasant sometimes, but he has a heart of gold. Nothing else to say about this. We'll talk about this. I don't talk about this anymore. Okay, right click. I'll be going. Okay, so we can return her at any time. Now we can't really, like... If we can walk around, I don't know what... Yeah, it's basically all a click interface. Okay, that's the second floor. You know what? We need, like, a tab. Oh, the tab brings this up. Never mind. We need a highlight selectable thing. Okay, so picture here. Okay. Is the Institute this old? Oop. Okay. The radiators weren't working, and it showed. The cold there was glacial. Poor Julia. I had no idea how to turn them on, otherwise I certainly would have tried. The Institute's state of disrepair is truly mind-boggling. No one cared enough to have emptied the trash cans yet. It certainly wouldn't be me who would empty those trash cans. There was no point in rummaging through the trash cans. It was just useless garbage. Mm. Were they planning to reopen the institute under these conditions? Unbelievable. The state of the chairs is almost begging you to leave the building. Maybe they didn't want any visitors. The chairs look barely usable. I couldn't believe this. The foyer, of all rooms, was just in such dire condition. This wasn't a welcoming sight. Julia's desk was sufficiently tidy, at least when compared with its surroundings. The imposing desk dominated the lower level of the foyer. That it did. An old but elegant grandfather clock, which unfortunately was no longer working. There was no secret passage inside this clock, sadly. I'm just going to look around this room first. It must have felt intimidating to sit right in the center of this large room. Oh, strange artwork. The Institute's state of disrepair was truly mind-boggling. Let's take a look in this room. Guys are wearing some kind of dress shoes or something. Visitors would spend their time in this waiting room until their turn came up. Right? Uninviting chairs also surrounded the waiting room. Useless as they were, the chairs couldn't even pass for decoration in such a broken state. There was a series of uninteresting magazines on the table, dated too. I hadn't come to the Institute to sit down and read gossip magazines. Well, why not? That goes... Oh! Dr. Hawthorne. So this must go back out. Altered. I began to remember the layout of the building. This was the administrative area with offices for a few key staff members. Janitor. This would be the ideal place to start looking into my past and the impenetrable secrets of the Hanwell Institute. The vast and lonely ocean extended as far as the eye could see. I felt like I was at the end of the world. Just as we came from them, one day we'll all return to the eternal waters. Very philosophical then. The dirty window made me feel disconnected somehow, as if the world out there wasn't real. These couldn't be open. In fact, most windows in the building couldn't. So there went my hope for fresh air. Well, you could always just go back outside. What about the janitors? Oh, dark. Not liking, really. It's too dark in here to see well. Okay, let's get the hell out. I thought Julia wouldn't appreciate me roaming inside these offices, so it's best to be cautious. Really. Well, unless there's a stealth option, which I don't think so. Dr. Hawthorne. The store is locked. Oh, this is the... This came from here, sorry. The waiting room. Dr. Ebershacker.